Hey everybody, it's Moonbow here, and welcome back to more Endless Scrap Mechanic. In today's video, it is time to revisit some giant builds. That is right, guys, so if you are unfamiliar with giant builds, I have done quite a few of them in the past. I've done some giant kitchen appliances, and a giant pinball machine and vending machine. It was a lot of fun, so if you guys do want to check out some of those past giant builds, then definitely go to the description, guys. I'll leave some links to those videos there, and you can see where it all began. But today's theme for giant builds is power tools. So over here to my left we have a chop saw. It is not quite a miter saw. Right behind me there is a table saw, and then to the right of that there is a cordless drill on wheels that we can actually drive around and drill into things. So of course these are all being used with spud guns and all sorts of mechanics as well. And right in front of me here I have some cardboard chunks that we are going to use to simulate pieces of wood, and we're going to try and do all sorts of awesome cutting and drilling with it. So we've got our giant tools right here, the chop saw, the table saw, the cordless drill, and me. Let's get into this. Alright, so we are going to start off with the chop saw, which is also known as a miter saw. So what this saw is usually used for is quick cuts at whichever angle that you would like to. Now, unfortunately, this is more of just a simple chop saw and not a miter saw, because I did not actually give it the capability to set the angle here. So you can see that this is just one straight area where the blade will come through. And normally though, this whole thing would spin around and the guard back here would stay in place. So that way you could create 30 degree, 45 degree angles and make your angled cuts. So this isn't technically a miter saw because you can't make miter joints with it. So it's just a simple chop saw, but you can see that it has a blade, it has a guard on the bottom here, the plastic guard, as well as the top guard. And then of course back here we have a whole bunch of stuff that is being used to power the chop saw. So what I normally do though is I will weld a piece of that cardboard block right here, and I'll try and chop it in half. So just to show you guys though what this looks like on the lift, so you guys get an idea of how it works, we'll pop it down right here like this. So you can see that it actually spawns straight up and down, and the reason why I actually did that was because originally I had it spawning on a horizontal plane, and because of that it was actually blocking this location right here. So when I want to try and weld my cardboard blocks, they would actually get redded out because this would be actually there. So now it just spawns up above it. But we're gonna head over here to our little lumber pile. We've got some finished cardboard lumber. So let's grab one of these blocks right here, and we are going to run it down to the chop saw. Now I will mention though, actually, before I weld this to the chop saw, I'm gonna weld the entire chop saw to the ground. All right, so the whole thing is welded to the ground. We just gotta hop over here and grab a spot somewhere. You know what, it doesn't really matter. Let's just grab it right around there. Pop that right there, break this off, and there we go. Look at that, guys, we now have a little piece of wood. So I guess we only wanna cut off a little chunk of it. I don't know what we would ever actually build with this thing, but all you got to do is hop into the seat right here. Now this is pretty simple, guys, so I'm gonna go through the buttons and switches to show you what it looks like. So the one key will lower the entire blade. So there's actually a few safety mechanisms, because you know what, guys, this is a good opportunity to talk about tool safety. If you're ever in the wood shop or any other type of shop, you always want to be aware of all the dangers and risks involved with using these types of things. All right, so we are ready to make our first cut. I've actually moved the cardboard block over to the right a bit just so we can get a bit better of a cut, but this is absolutely awesome, guys. This thing won't actually work until we get all of the safety mechanisms going. So let's lift up the guard there, and we have the blade spinning, and all we got to do now, guys, is actually start chopping. So let's see what happens here. All right, we're gonna lower the blade. There it goes. It is starting to cut the wood. Oh my goodness. Look at that, guys. This is truly impressive. And there we go. Look at that. It makes no effort whatsoever when it comes to cutting a big chunk like that. But let's actually just drop the guard back down so this thing is safe to use again. And look at that, guys. We have chopped that chunk of cardboard right in half. Now, I'm not gonna lie, that is not a very accurate cut, though. That is that's pretty poor when it comes to accuracy. I don't know what I would ever be able to use that for as far as a project goes, but this saw is so much fun to use. I love being able to just chop stuff in half. Now, obviously, like I mentioned, this is using spud guns, so I actually have two very simple spud gun turrets mounted on the inside right here. And all it simply does is it launches a whole bunch of spuds right down this little section right here, and it'll chop anything in half. So we can actually just get this whole thing going again without any wood there. And you can actually see that it's shooting the spuds, and then the whole saw just goes right into the seat right there. So if we go underneath it, we can actually see right here that the entire thing is spinning really, really fast in that little tiny slot. And that's pretty much just like an actual saw, miter saw that you would see in real life. So I think I did a pretty good job staying relatively accurate to this, but let's actually just chop this piece of wood in half one more time. All right, here we go in 3, 2, 1, start dropping it down. Oh boy, oh geez, the way it kicks back like that is incredible. All right, can we maybe need to drop the saw up and down here? You know, the first cut didn't get all the way through. And okay, you know what? Ooh, hold on here. Let's turn that blade off. All right, there we go. We chopped through that, no problem whatsoever. My goodness, this saw actually works extremely well. All right, you know what? Hold on here. We got to do one more. Just get rid of the sawdust there. All right, and the final cut. Here we go, guys. Drop that saw right down. Look at that. Wow. That was so fast. Okay, I am actually truly impressed by this saw now. Look at that. This thing is so cool. All right, and I mean, this thing is definitely dangerous though, guys. You do not want to hurt yourself. Okay, wait, am I guess it doesn't really, okay, it doesn't really do anything to me. All right, so here is the giant cordless drill. Now, this thing is actually quite simple, guys. It is literally just one single spud gun on the end. I was thinking of ways that I could do it with multiple spud guns, and in the end, it actually didn't seem like it would really work out. So one spud gun is all we're gonna be using. And all we gotta do though is just hop right into the seat here, just like this, and check this out, guys. So let's just actually kind of steer away from our giant block of wood there. So if we press the one key, you can see that it actually starts to shoot the entire thing just like that. And we also have pistons right here so that we can actually raise up and down the entire thing so we can drill at different levels. Now, another thing I actually want to mention is I do have a motor right here attached to the end of the drill right here like this. So that way you can actually see when we press it, the entire thing does actually start to spin like a drill. Now, let's actually just do a quick test drill with the spinning, and I'll show you guys why I actually had to get rid of it. All right, so let's just kind of line up our spot right here. You know what, actually, let's just go up a little bit higher. I think we want to hang this picture right about here, and let's start drilling into this thing. All right, there we go, and we are just going to slowly drive in, and you know what, it seems like I'm not actually having any problems whatsoever. All right, look at that, we are drilled all the way through. Look, that's absolutely amazing and smooth as butter. Now, oh, look at that, we actually did go all the way through. I wasn't sure if this thing was going to be thick enough or not to actually not matter, but in the end, the spud gun is going to shoot all the way through anyway. So this thing is absolutely fantastic though. I love being able to just drill a hole like that, and you know, I mean, you can kind of simulate using a drill. So let's actually just kind of hop up here on the lift, take a look at that. All right, so that's actually a pretty good hole. You can see it kind of made it one way and then switched over to the other side. But the fun part about this is actually when you start to do weird angled drill holes. So that's why I put this thing on wheels. So I'm gonna drive up to this block of cardboard on an angle right here at the corner, just like that. And we are gonna try and drill through on this angle here. So let's start spinning it up, slowly driving in. And okay, there we go. We are now drilling in ever so slightly. Oh, we're getting stuck. There we go. And we will stop there and try, can we, okay, hold on here, can we, I don't know if I can back up. Okay, the drill is stuck. Uh-oh, this is not good. Either way though, we can hop around the backside of this block of cardboard here. Let's see, okay, there it is, guys. The drill was definitely going in at a pretty good angle, and I think we can get a kind of better view of it. There it is, there's the drill bit right there. Kind of unrealistically poking through the other side, but nonetheless, that is just so much fun. But now that drill bit is definitely stuck in there, guys. So you know what, normally what I would do if a drill bit gets stuck is you just break it off just like that. Sometimes you have to just ditch a drill bit because it is old and worn out and you gotta replace it. So I guess I'll just have to replace that one. All right, and last but not least, we have ourselves the table saw. That is right, guys. The table saw is a very useful saw. It is used usually for cutting very long straight lines in long pieces of plywood and stuff like that. So I have made myself some cardboard plywood right here. Take a look at this, guys. So we're gonna be using this. We're gonna pop it up there and try and chop it in half. But before we do that, let's actually just kind of do a quick little run through of this table saw. As you can see, there is another little spud gun turret here, and that is going to shoot spuds right through that little slot. And there's even a second one right here just to make sure it gets all of the cardboard. Because guys, I mean, look at this. You can see right here, if we actually get a really close look, it looks like it's smooth. But I mean, if we zoom in really close, like zoom in closer and closer. Okay, there you go. Now, look at that, guys. You can see that there are actually microscopic little teeth on this saw blade. And that is actually how we are cutting this cardboard. Alright, so we are up here on the table saw now. So this is actually a pretty cool build. I had to make a few modifications to make it work a little more consistently. This was actually the hardest one of all three to build. So this though, you just press the one key and look at that, guys. You can see that the entire saw blade starts to spin. We also have the two key. Now the two key is used for an adjustable little guard right here that actually is used as a rail. So that way if you did have your pieces of wood or cardboard on this little spot right here that pushes it, then this is where you would set it so that you can actually measure the distance between here and here and get a set distance in your cut on the plywood. So you can actually change that though by adjusting your piston right here. I mean, you don't really actually need to use this though, because it will actually just end up stopping your block of wood from moving, because that is scrap mechanic physics. So all we have to do is actually weld some of that plywood over here on the table saw. So we're just gonna grab our weld tool, grab a chunk of lumber just like that, and walk back over here, and there we go. We are gonna weld it right there. Now, normally I would detach stuff like this, but I can't detach it, because if I do, it causes a lot of problems in the game, and I wanna actually mention something about table saws. So normally, a table saw would have the ability to make this blade go down and hide itself. So what you can actually do with a table saw is create a lot of different unique cuts, as well as, of course, keep it safe. So normally this saw blade, I had a piston back here that actually lowered the entire saw blade so that it would break the surface of the table and it would actually stay hidden below this actual surface right here. So why that's so useful though on a table saw is because, say this blade is set right now, I guess we could say it's set to what, two blocks maybe, 2.5 blocks or so because of the angled pieces there spinning on a circle. But if we wanted to set it to just one single block, what would happen is we would just cut right through a little section here and leave a channel of wood, which is called a dado. So we'd be able to do a dado cut. You can actually get special blades that change the thickness of the blade as well to create different dados. And it's a beautiful thing on a table saw, but I mean, this is scrap mechanics, so let's just chop some wood. All right, here we go in 3, 2, 1, let's start moving that wood, and there we go, guys. The saw is now chopping right through it. Oh, look at that. It looks like such a beautiful, smooth cut. Oh man, this is so satisfying to watch. I love the satisfying spud gun destruction in this game. All right, look at that. All right, so let's just pull it back here, and oh, careful. All right, I better just turn that saw blade off. Look at this, guys. So we have actually successfully cut this block of wood in half, and it looks like it actually did a great job of doing it in a straight line. And of course the other piece up here is still attached right here to that chunk, so let's just kind of remove this. And you know what, I actually want to try and do some type of dado style cut, so let's try that out with a bigger block of wood. All right, so we've got a bigger block of cardboard on the table now, so let's see if we can actually create that dado effect. So let's start spinning the blade. And here we go, guys. It's time to try this thing out. All right, this is gonna be interesting. I wonder if it's actually gonna be able to kind of saw through it. Okay, there it goes. The saw blade is now doing its work. And look at that, guys. It is, okay, no, it's not as smooth as I thought it was going to be, but it is definitely pushing through. All right, and I think the piston has reached its end right there. So we can actually stop the blade from spitting spuds out and it won't cut anymore. But look at this, guys. This is the dado style cut. Now, I'm not too sure how good of a cut that actually is. So why don't we free this thing from the entire table saw? We're gonna grab it on the lift and we are going to just kind of flip it over here. And this will give us a better idea of how good of a cut that was. Alright, so looking at it, we can see that the depth is not very smooth at all, but I mean, nonetheless, it definitely did what I wanted it to do, which was create a bit of a dado effect where it didn't cut all the way through, but it did leave a little bit out, so you can actually see the spuds overshot right here at this end. But nonetheless, guys, that is so cool. So that is going to be the video for today, guys. I do hope you did enjoy this spud gun destruction and these builds, and if you did, then definitely let me know by hitting that like button, guys. And if you want to see more Endless Scrap Mechanic, then consider subscribing to the channel, maybe even turning on some of those notifications so you can get the latest and the craziest coming from me in Scrap Mechanic. So thank you so much, everybody, for tuning in, and I'll be seeing you in the next one. So bye for now.